Hey Aries, welcome to Eight of Cups Tarot. I'm working on your reading for February. And right off the gate, I just want to say thanks for being a giant pain in the ass. And no pun intended, but I literally did the same spread that I've been doing for each of the sign. And I got about halfway through and it just felt very, very forced. And so I picked it up and something told me that this was not going to be the typical reading. Aries, you're kind of demanding a different type of energy. And in that way, it was sort of like this reading isn't about anybody else but Aries. That was made very clear. So let's take a look at the energy that you're stepping in before we get to these cards. And the first thing that comes to mind is the Venus in Aries in your first house. So there's like this balance almost between the masculine and the feminine. I mean, if you think about it, you have Aries, this is your dominant masculine Mars persona, and then you're bringing to it the drive, the passion, the heart, the soul, the ability to create abundance. So you're pulling both the masculine and the feminine energy there in your first house. Now, this could bring magnetism. So this is the ability and the manifestation for money, for attraction, for love. And just quite honestly, speaking of exactly what you need, it is the communication and the acknowledging. Uranus is getting triggered as well here. So again, it's that need for freedom coming through in your second house. So I think a lot of Aries are working through issues where, maybe you can't work a 9 to 5 or you just don't want to be burdened by a 40 to 50 hour a week career. Maybe there's something that you're looking at that you need a different, a change or some sort of freedom in the way that you create money and abundance in your life. And, there's sort of, we're on the precipice of a changing of the guards in May. The North Node is going to shift from Cancer, your fourth house, over to Gemini, which is your third house. And that's really big for Aries because, like I said, you're starting to step into that energy of just making it known exactly what you want, what you need, what your expectations are, and being very clear and concise with those around you. There's a high level of negotiation here. And the full moon in Leo in your fifth house that happened this weekend, I feel like this is a real starting point, maybe addressing the blocks in your ability to create, the blocks in your ability to date or bring romance into your life, connection and sex, wherever there were blocks there and where you were not experiencing maybe the progress that you had expected to make. I think there's breakthroughs coming there. And you have Mars, this week extremely active as it goes through the end points of Sagittarius. We're going to pass over the galactic point, and that's going to bring a lot of energy through all of the fire signs as well. You have Venus in your first house hitting Chiron, so that's creating events that are going to be called for healing. And then Mars going over that galactic point in your ninth house, this is telling me that you're going to be very strong with your beliefs, with your convictions. And that's moving towards your 10th house. Mars is going to go into your 10th house, creating enormous drive and support and ambition towards your career, your path, your destiny in this lifetime. And so there's a lot of that energy that's building. And then you kind of have this retrograde Mercury. There's like this soft spot. There's a release that Aries has. There's a very romantic place you can go, because there are going to be times where you need to release. You need to step out of this drive and this power and move into a softer side. And so that retrograde Mercury in your 12th house, you may be experiencing a lot of nostalgia, people coming back from the past. This is also a time when you could meet new people that are karmic or soulmate type, you know, relationships in your life. You can attract that in. I just said that at 555. Interesting. So, you know, there's also a little bit of maybe being okay with the not knowing. There's just a small fuzzy area in the Aries lives in which they're willing to play around with, I think. They're willing to not have to determine certain outcomes and just kind of play and let those things be. So I see a lot of ambition and a lot of drive in the Aries as usual, but I think it's really, I think the energy is ready to go. But there's also a place of healing. There's still some stuff happening behind the scenes. And so I'm seeing a mastery. You're near the end of the process and ready to go. But sometimes it's a little bit darkest before the dawn. I feel like you're kind of seeing that right now. So let's dive into these cards. What did I say about that 555? All right, perfect. So, you had me do a completely different layout, and that's fine. But let me tell you, as I just said, that Mars is moving over that galactic point in your ninth house in Sag, and the first card, center of everything, is the Justice card. So Aries, I think overall this month, there's a reckoning of what is truly meant for you. And so let's go through this energy. Seven of Cups, Three of Swords, High Priestess. All right, so Aries, here's what we're getting clear on, okay? This energy, the Seven of Cups, this is the distractions, the shiny things. And they're where we lose our footing. And I feel like Aries, like I said, there's this soft place. Somewhere deep in your subconscious, there's a nostalgia, a need to create these really beautiful stories. But this is what's holding you back, okay? Because it's okay to go there. It's okay to have those beautiful stories. But you're creating situations in your mind and you're breaking your own heart, okay? You're creating these illusions. So this is where, and sometimes this happens with Venus in your sign, is that you create a fantasy of what you think a person is. And then reality comes and you realize that that person is not the illusion you had in your mind the entire time. But there's always a part of you that knows exactly what you did, Aries. There's a part of you that knows that you abandoned your intuition and you created this story which broke your own heart, okay? So there's a realization of this pattern. There's a realization that instead of allowing or waiting for that perfect thing to come along, we just kind of grab the next thing and we shine it up, you know, kind of like buff out the blemishes, and we say, this is it. And then we have to act completely shocked when that's not it at all. The Two of Wands coming out under the Seven of Cups. This is a significant shift in energy here. So this goes from building illusions and fantasies. This is tricky, hazy, Neptunian, okay? But this speaks to me of Uranus. This speaks to me of higher visions, but with focus and with drive. Instead of getting lost in all of the possibilities, it's choosing that one thing and seeing it through to what you want it to be. And coming out under the High Priestess is the Two of Swords. So it's very important that the decisions reached in the month of February are made with that intuition, in that knowing. It's so important if you are an Aries and you are not participating in some form of a meditation or a clarity break or a time to kind of quiet things down, maybe do some journaling. It doesn't really have to be all that spiritual. It's just the allowing of the mind to talk to you, the allowing of the soul, of the higher being to talk to you instead of the mind. There's a sacred place here that I think Aries are getting really comfortable in. There's a knowing to the decisions that you're making. There's, I feel like, less hesitation. And I say that because, you know, crowning that Justice card was the Three of Swords. So it's kind of like, it's the infinitive determination that this will not be allowed anymore. You know, there's an idea of what you do have control over. And although, Aries, you don't have control over other people, you cannot force somebody to love you or stay with you or, you know, but you can address the issues within you. So just like we talked about, kind of getting our hearts set on these fantasies that we create and realizing that we get exactly what we deserve in these situations. And so we have to start getting really clear about the things that we want, the things that we deserve, and the things that we're willing to accept. And I think the Three of Swords, along with the Justice card, says we're not afraid to say it anymore. There's no fear in saying, you know what, I just don't date people that, you know, I don't, just being really honest about the things that you need up front and being really open to the other person's honesty. So if somebody tells you, I don't really want any more kids, and Aries, you're sitting there thinking, but maybe we could talk about that and it'll change later. Like, no more of that. Like, this is okay. That's not going to work. On to the next. I see Aries getting really serious about the dream and less worried about the players here. There's a little bit of the ability of having faith that the universe is going to provide you with the people and the resources that you need as soon as you get to a place where you're ready to move. And that is why I see a shift from the creating to the producing, to the I see this now as the protecting, seeing the value and the protecting of the idea, the protecting of the dream as it comes into fruition. I think that Aries is very aware of the fragility of this in its early stages, and you want to protect that more than anything. And so there's a quietness as well, Aries. There's a maybe the less divulging of the plans to others because now these are things that are very sacred to you. And sacred because we're talking about this energy. Okay. So you have a Knight of Cups next to the Star card and the Nine of Wands. So that tells me that not only is your dream worth protecting, but someone else thinks so too. Okay? And it's like in the moment when you begin to acknowledge yourself and the special place that you have, the special thing that you offer, you'll immediately be seen for who you truly are. And in the matter that you want it to come in, okay? Because crowning the Star card is the Justice card. So Aries knows exactly what they deserve. They know exactly what the karma is coming in, okay? And they know that it's something big. I think the Aries knows that they're on to the next big thing. That this is just a little bump or a little delay or a little bit of a challenge, maybe in getting past some of the final destructuring before we move into this ultimate phase of creation. Now, this could be a new relationship, it could be a new job offer, it could just simply be a gift from the universe, it could just be a moment when you're driving to work and you look up at the sky and things seem so beautiful, and all of a sudden you are flooded with a feeling of gratitude. It could be something that simple, but it is a feeling nonetheless, and it is a feeling that you have to connect to at all times because you know how fragile this is. And I think you know how special this is. And I think that you know that by making the choices in the trusting of your intuition, the universe has no choice but to deliver you exactly what you deserve. And there's no greater knight to come towards you than the Knight of Cups, because this is a emotional, loving offer. This is built on all of those good things, all of the good things that you imagined all of the other people in the past may have brought, but they didn't. And so discernment over this past several months, The dissolving and the understanding of the ego in a very healthy way, when to be vulnerable, when to protect yourself. I think that these lessons have gotten you into a place where you are ready for the next big thing. And the overall energy, bottom of the deck, is the devil. Now, I see a lot of Saturn here when I look at this. You may be dealing with a Capricorn or working with a Capricorn. But I also see here that Aries is getting really comfortable in the self-discipline, in the place where you know when to react and when to... you know, there's times when an Aries wants to bulldoze through stuff. But I think this conjunction, this Saturn-Pluto conjunction in your 10th house, I think this has changed the tone for you. And there's been a little bit of learning how, by adding that earthy element, I think it's getting you to a point where you're realizing that with a little bit of patience, with a little bit of strategy, how much more progress you can make. And even just in the comfort of patience and allowing the waiting to come through, I think Aries is getting a little bit more comfortable with patience. Now, astrology cards that came out for the month, you got Aquarius and Leo. So these are signs that are exact opposite of each other. The Aquarius, the I know, this talks about that intuition that you're learning to trust. And then the Leo talks about that fire, that acknowledging your passions and your dreams and the drive to go after them. This also talks about your 5th and 11th house. So this is, you know, where you had the full moon in your 5th house. This is using the discernment, using the knowledge, the ability to allow yourself to stand out and to be seen, you know, and to demand what you deserve. You got two really beautiful cards from the Work Your Light Tarot, the Oracle cards. And this also speaks to that Leo card. Play. Have fun. Celebrate. And don't be so serious. Okay, that's really great. So there is that element again of don't get so distracted by all of the shiny things. You know, you want to invest in all the things and everything is this wonderful possibility. There's a discernment and then you can kind of get lost in the creating of it. Like this is where you want to get lost. You don't want to get lost here. You don't want to get lost in illusions, right? You want to get lost in the things that you're going to create. Your own world. What you have control over. You also got the card Awakening. Energetic upgrades, a new way of being, and integration. I really feel like Aries is stepping into this really beautiful place where your masculine and feminine is really balanced right now. There's a knowing of when to receive and a knowing of when to go out and get, you know? And I think Aries is doing a great job discerning that energy. And whatever comes in through this retrograde Mercury in your 12th house, I think that you're going to be really prepared for because you're going to be comfortable trusting that intuition and that inner knowing that you didn't maybe trust in previous decades, let's just say. But now with this conjunction, with the learning of the lessons and knowing that you have to go about things differently, this is when Aries starts to see the rewards, but it's still slow. It's still coming in. And when they talk to you about play, remember with manifesting that you want to manifest the emotions, the gratitude. You have to pretend like you already have that thing that you really want and really resonate with the happiness and the joy that it brings you in knowing that you have it. And so there's the no paying attention to the lack. You know better than to focus on the things that you do not have. And you also know better than to create these really specific outcomes in your mind or attaching yourself to a certain person or a scenario or that things have to look a certain way in order for it to be what you are hoping for. There's an openness with Aries that they're open to the opportunities that the universe wants to bring you, and you know that the universe is a little bit smarter than you are. So there's the knowing of when to explore things, and then the knowing of when to cut things off and what to invest in and what to give your energy to. The animal spirit card you pulled is the golden egg. So I'm telling you, Aries, we're on to big things. They're starting. I think Aries is going to see come April. I think the world's going to be a much different place for Aries. I mean, for all of us. But I think Aries is going to see a very large structural change in their lives. Golden egg. Message at the center of the heart, the unstruck sound. Within the golden egg lives a precious sound. Deep within that sound resides a message. The sound cannot be heard, nor the message discerned until we retreat from the noise of modern day life. The magical essence of the golden egg needs warmth, quiet, and time to unfold. No rushing, pushing, or grasping. Find a place of deep and restful ease, perhaps through yoga nidra or meditation. If you do not yet have a meditation practice, take some time for introspection or contemplation. When the mind begins to settle and the breath is calm, ask the question that weighs heaviest on your heart, staying open to any response you hear. Engaging with the energy of the golden egg is an advanced practice. It requires becoming intimate with our very essence and comfortable with vulnerability. When a feeling of tenderness or gratitude arises from deep within you, know that you are well on your way. Oh, I just love that. All right, Aries, I wish you so much luck this month. I'm going to be back very soon with the mid-month love reading. So until then, hang in there. Stay in this energy because I really like it for you. I cannot wait to see what March is going to bring you. Lots of love. Bye.